Hello and welcome to the news. I'm Ankita Mukherjee. Worrying data over India's rising COVID numbers and today warnings from the government as well. Let's get started with the headlines tonight. The centre red flags a sudden surge in COVID cases in 14 cities. The positivity rate in Kolkata is the highest among metros at 12.5%. As India reports over 10,000 daily cases after a period of 1 month, the government says mask up. This is the final frontier. Mumbai alone reports 3,671 new COVID cases, a 46% jump over yesterday's figure. As cases surge, COVID war rooms are reactivated. We bring you a ground report. As massive crowds gather at election rallies amid this COVID surge, officials are passing the buck. It's the domain of the Election Commission, says the COVID Task Force Chief. The EC says it's not in charge until after polls are announced. The GST Council will meet tomorrow. The proposed hike on textiles and footwear, among other things, could be deferred. Those new rates were supposed to have come into effect from the 1st of January. Arrests for hate speech in other states, but not in Uttarakhand. The Chhattisgarh police arrest the man who abused Mahatma Gandhi. But no arrests yet in BJP-ruled Uttarakhand for the Haridwar hate speeches, which called for genocide of an entire community. In Nagaland, special protection to the army is extended. A six-month extension of AFSPA, despite the massive protests and civil gatherings after the botched operation that saw 14 civilians being killed. From its lowest cases this year, just 9 days ago, India tonight has the highest number of COVID cases it has seen in 2 months. As the R factor or reproduction factor rises above the critical level of one, active cases have jumped by 5,400. That's also the sharpest rise we've seen in 4 months. Take a look at this. And that image really is self-explanatory. From 5,326 cases on the 21st of December, which was also the lowest this year, just 9 days later, 13,154 cases. Look at the steep, steep rise. While flagging this sudden rise in COVID cases across 14 cities, the center has written to states urging them to take immediate measures to check the surge. Cases of the highly infectious Omicron are also increasing rapidly in and around big cities. The center's advice was take steps now to avoid increased mortality. The idea of taking Delhi's graded response action plan model across the country is also being considered, according to sources. In Delhi, the state's health minister talked about the rise in Omicron cases among the share of total COVID cases.
Police removing angry protesters blocking a South Delhi road. Angry at not enough buses being deployed after seating was limited to 50% because of the surge in COVID cases. But it's not just Delhi. Across the country, positivity rates and cases have shot up this week. Kolkata's positivity rate is very high at 12.5%. All this has prompted the center to write to states today asking to take proactive and immediate action. They have also asked the states to take steps now to avoid increased mortality. While Omicron cases have risen by 23% since yesterday, COVID cases have jumped faster by 43%.
This push is a part of the global upsurge, which is related to Omicron severity. Hopefully mild, but cannot be taken for granted. There is no need to panic because as a nation we are prepared.
कोरोना के अंदर 46 ओमिक्रॉन के 46%
वो कम्युनिटी दिल्ली में कम से कम कम्युनिटी के अंदर है
बिल्कुल जा रहा है धीरे धीरे जा रहा है कम्युनिटी के अंदर भी जा रहा है
फॉर नाउ देयर आर नो न्यू कर्व्स बट अथॉरिटीज इन दिल्ली एंड अदर सिटीज आर ट्रैकिंग केसेस एंड डेटा वेरी क्लोजली द कॉमन मैसेज इज डोंट पैनिक वी आर प्रिपेयर्ड दिस टाइम बट एवरीबॉडी मस्ट बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल वेयर मास्क बी सोशली डिस्टेंस्ड एंड दोज एलिजिबल मस्ट बी फुली वैक्सीनेटेड
As the number of Omicron cases rise across the country, healthcare experts warn that any lapse in following COVID-appropriate behavior can result in another devastating wave of COVID-19. And while the central government is writing to the states advising stricter restrictions, only its implementation on the ground can yield desirable results. With camera person Pujaria, I'm Akshay Dongre for NDTV.
The government today also talked about the rollout of precautionary vaccine doses, primarily to mitigate the severity of infections, hospitalizations and deaths. That's going to start from the 10th of January, as already announced. Now, India also has a new weapon in its arsenal against COVID, the antiviral drug molnupiravir, which will be given to those who have mild to moderate infections and will be a prescription-only pill. Vishnu Shom spoke to the manufacturer of the recently cleared COVID pill for India.
You are going to be producing one of the weapons which we need. How many doses have you already manufactured?
Yeah, we are targeting to manufacture 40 million capsules per month, so which is equivalent to 10 lakh doses.
What is the cost of the course?
Yeah, per course, roughly about 2,500 rupees to 2,600 rupees is the course.
And that course, correct me if I'm wrong, is 40 pills, right, over 5 days?
40 pills, yeah. Future, definitely it is possible to come definitely below this cost.
At what stage does a patient take it?
Yeah, this is to be administered only when he's become a positive, COVID positive. So the moment he became a COVID positive, this is mainly administered for the mild to moderate COVID patients.
Mumbai today saw a massive surge in fresh coronavirus cases with 3,671 infections. Now, that's a 46% jump from yesterday amid concerns over the third wave and the Omicron variant. In Mumbai, health workers are now working around the clock in shifts across 24 wards to test, trace and treat patients. Saurabh Gupta sends us this ground report from one of Mumbai's COVID war rooms.
Mumbai's civic body, the PMC, has reactivated its ward-level war rooms to tackle the spike in cases. Mumbai has recorded a staggering spike in the number of cases over the last few days. And doctors say most of this, at least they say they're certain, but of course it'll be confirmed only by genome sequencing results, that could be driven by the Omicron variant. But to tackle the surge, these ward-level war rooms are already functional. They've been reactivated. These war rooms played a key role during the devastating second wave. Is there anything different this time? How are you going about the ward war room?
Cases are increased since last 2 days. We are getting cases above 100 and today it is above 200. So the calling has been increased from war room. Every day we get a list, line list, positive line list for the citizens who stay in K East ward. We start calling them. The same list is received by the health post. We have 12 health posts in this ward. So once we start tracing the patients, we take all the details from them. We take their symptoms, travel history, and on basis of that, we do their admission.
The data, the details of somebody who's positive is being taken down here. He said home quarantine. He said he's been vaccinated and that data has been noted. And they will keep calling him to keep track of patients who've tested positive. If Mumbai requires, further help, further information and help with triage, then these war rooms will be functional in the days to come. In Mumbai, with camera person Praveen G. Rohit, Saurabh Gupta, NDTV.
In the midst of this new COVID surge, the government has one important message: mask up, mask up, mask up. They say masking is really the final frontier to help us weather through the Omicron surge. Well, we have that same message coming in from health professionals around the country as they hope this time hospitals will not and health infrastructure will not be brought to the brink of collapse.
Mask remains the final frontier.
That our best vaccination is masking. It not only prevents the Omicron, Delta, Beta, Alpha, every form of respiratory virus. So your best bet of staying away from any form of COVID is to wear a mask and of course follow the other norms.
In India, if you look into it, 961 cases per day is happening. Cover the face, nose as well as the mouth and a 1 meter distance.
Please wear the mask. This pandemic we will win by wearing a mask and getting vaccinated.
So mask wearing is most important. Whether you are taking a vaccination or not, the mask is must.
Please wear masks properly and the proper masks. That means surgical masks or N95 masks.
लेने के बावजूद भी हमको COVID appropriate behavior जैसे मास्क लगाना है, हाथ धोना है और सामाजिक अंतर बनाए रखना है, इसका हमको पालन करना बहुत जरूरी है.
देखो मास्क ये एक ही पर्याय है, आप और कुछ भी नहीं करेंगे, सिर्फ मास्क अगर ईमानदारी से बनेंगे तो अपन इसे 99% तक रोक सकते हैं, इतना जरूरतमंद है ये.
Well, there are some places where that advice isn't being followed at all, and those are the massive election rallies that are taking place in several states, particularly Uttar Pradesh right now, right in the middle of this COVID surge. Crowds of tens of thousands are gathering, many without masks and with zero social distancing. Well, today the centre said it was the poll panel's responsibility to ensure safety steps. The poll panel passed the buck as well, saying it can't interfere until election dates are formally announced. COVID precautions have been violated at all political rallies, be they of the BJP, the Aam Aadmi Party, the SP or the Congress. Also in the presence of top leaders, including the Prime Minister. So just who will take responsibility?
The Centre and the Election Commission passing the buck over whose job it is to stop COVID safety violations at political rallies, despite the government warning of a sudden surge and a potential rise in deaths.
In regard to the specific issue of elections, as we communicated last time, this is for the Honorable Election Commission it is in the domain of the Honorable Election Commission.
देखिए जब भी चुनाव होता है, हमारा चुनाव आयोग का जब दायित्व शुरू होता है, जब हम MCC लागू कर देते हैं, उससे पहले जो भी वर्क है वो स्टेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन का होता है और SDMA के अंतर्गत जो भी उनकी कार्यवाही होगी वो लोग करेंगे. And whenever the elections will be announced, this point will be definitely considered, how the big rallies are to be managed or whether digital communication will have to be increased.
But that announcement is several days away at least. For now, rallies continue across parties. Prime Minister Narendra Modi was in Uttarakhand's Haldwani to lay the foundation stone for projects worth 23,000 crores. Home Minister Amit Shah was in UP, holding rallies in the western part. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal led this Aam Aadmi Party Yatra in Chandigarh, while the Bahujan Samaj Party's Satish Mishra addressed a rally in UP's Jhansi. The Congress's Priyanka Gandhi Vadra was at a rally in Firozabad on Wednesday.
The question is, what happens in the next 1 or 2 weeks with these rallies and as they take place without COVID protocol? That's the question for which we do not seem to have any answers right now.
At this Lucknow press conference, the Chief Election Commissioner said, all Uttar Pradesh political parties have asked for polls to be held on time despite the COVID threat, but agreed that curbs were needed in poll rallies. The Election Commission will increase polling time by an hour so that social distancing norms can be followed. The Election Commission has directed officials to ensure each of UP's 15 crore plus voters are vaccinated at least with one dose, but no eligible voter will be denied the right to vote.
देखिए चुनाव समय से होना चाहिए, जो तीसरी लहर की बात आई है हम लोगों की पूरी तैयारी है, वैक्सीन सभी की दूसरी डोज लग चुकी है, अब कोई बात की चिंता नहीं है।
उत्तर प्रदेश वीकली केसेस आर राइजिंग बाय ओवर 150%, although in absolute numbers it is a little over 400. At such a rate numbers could surge, a threat our politicians or government bodies do not seem to be taking seriously just yet. With Arshad Jamal, Akshay Dongre and Rajesh Gupta, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.
Report now on the COVID situation in Kerala, where there was a rush before night curfew began. Sneha Koshi with that report.
Morning rush to buy fish, there's zero social distancing. Masks are sometimes off. It's not just the rush of office goers in Thiruvananthapuram city. Malls like this one packed with families. About 1 lakh visitors a day. From food courts to children's play area, it is almost full house. Though to their credit, most are wearing masks. This is shortly before the night curfew and travel restrictions across Kerala. From 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. till 2nd January to keep New Year gatherings low-key. No celebrations allowed post 10 p.m. on New Year Eve.
These restrictions are necessary, obviously, to put down the disease. But during daytime, it's more necessary because it's a lot of crowd everywhere during the daytime.
Even though there are restrictions, no one follows this. It's like out of control. So I don't know how they're going to bring it under control again.
Kerala, including its capital Thiruvananthapuram, has been seeing a decline in daily COVID cases, with the test positivity rate down to 3.88% compared to 10.5% in the beginning of November. 64 Omicron cases have been reported since the first confirmed case in the state on 12th December.
We are not going for any containment measures at this point of time. Containment will just reduce or will keep people from just working from their livelihood. And I think that may be one reason for curfew rather than going for some restrictions in daytime. But at this point of time, we have to check the transmission by COVID-appropriate behaviours.
The next 2 weeks or so are very crucial according to authorities and would be key to deciding what the state's next containment strategy is going to be, when the focus would remain as saving lives but also livelihoods. With camera person SP Babu, Sneha Koshi for NDTV.
The other big story, the GST Council will be meeting tomorrow. And top of their agenda will be the possible deferment of GST hike on textiles and footwear below 1,000 rupees. Now, the GST hike was scheduled to start from the 1st of January. GST had been hiked from 5 to 12% on textiles and on some categories of footwear. Now, all states, it seems, want the textile GST hike rolled back. Another controversial announcement has been the 5% GST on food supplies by e-commerce players, and that could come into effect from the 1st of January as well. The Chhattisgarh police has arrested Kali Charan Maharaj from neighbouring Madhya Pradesh and charged him with sedition 4 days after an FIR was registered against him for abusing Mahatma Gandhi. He's being brought to Chhattisgarh, where he will be taken to court. That's not all. Other states have also taken steps and made arrests against those spouting hate speech, but not Uttarakhand. There, the Haridwar hate mongers continue to walk free several days after the event.
The man who insulted and abused Mahatma Gandhi and spread hate from a religious congregation of saints in Raipur, now arrested. Kali Charan was arrested from Khajuraho in Madhya Pradesh under the following charges. Section 124A, that is sedition. Section 153A, that is promoting enmity between different groups on grounds of religion and race. Section 295A, that is malicious acts to outrage religious feelings. The hate saint tried to dodge the cops by booking a guest house but staying at a rented house a few kilometers away. But his arrest led to an interstate war between Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, with the MP Home Minister unhappy with the manner of the arrest.
Kalisharan ji ne jo bola wo bhi aapattijanak tha. Jis tarah se inne girafdari ki hai ye bhi aapattijanak hai.
Cops earlier have made arrests in other states as well. The UP police has made several arrests from Delhi, and Bihar police travelled to Mumbai to investigate in the Sushant Singh Rajput case in 2020. The matter instantly turned political with a sharp retort from the Chhattisgarh CM.
Narottam Mishra ji, ye bata hai ki Mahatma Gandhi ko gali dene wale vyakti ki giraftari se wo khush hai ya dukhi hai. Dusri baat ye hai ki kisi niyam ka ullanghan nahi hua hai.
Chhattisgarh police registered an FIR on the complaint filed by Congress leader Pramod Dubey, who himself was present in the Dharm Sansad. Now it has to be seen whether Congress will take actions against those leaders who invited such people to Raipur.
While arrests have taken place against Kalicharan, the heat is on the cops in Uttarakhand, a BJP-ruled state, who far from arresting the hate saints, was spotted sharing a nice laugh with them. 12 days on, only summons have been issued. And that too against three people. The principal accused in the case, who allegedly wanted Muslims killed, Yati Narsinghanan, has neither been arrested nor has he been named in the FIR. His brazenness is now visible in his claim that he has the cops by his side. With Anurag Dwari, Bureau Report, NDTV.